Hey guys, this is the story of my 2004 Jetta GLS 1.8 Turbo. And as mentioned in my big car video, I did buy this instead of a Neon SRT4 one day. And the picture isn't quite clear enough here. I can just barely make out the total MSRP on this. This was a pretty high-end GLS model loaded, $22,595. This was back in 2004. This was 11 years ago. Can you imagine getting a loaded VW for like under $23,000? That was crazy. And so it was galaxy blue. I believe it was 15-inch rims. It was 15-inch rims way back then. This was a long time ago. And the front was, I liked a lot, just a classic Jetta look. The rear, it had really nice tips. The 2005 specifically had a little different back end, different taillights than the 2004. I really liked the clear there. It wasn't so ricey because it went really well with the blue there. So I always loved the back end of this car. Interior was fairly clean. Remember these old Sirius add-on modules way back in the day? Those were hilarious. These cars had the crappiest stereos of all. It was a 5-speed, not a 6. And it just had like a low, medium, high knobs that basically sucked. This whole stereo sucked. It was called a monsoon system. Remember, you could get a fat box back in that day, which was like a hard drive to put in your trunk to store all your MP3s. This was like old technology. It did have the seat heaters here, you can see. That's pretty cool. And for the next picture, it had the leather seats, very nice leather, very comfortable, like all the VW seats, really nice seats. I definitely love the leather. And a simple cluster, not too fancy really, but it did the job. You can see I kept this 23,000 miles because these picks right here were my for sale picks. So it's a good indicator. I never knew that before, but it looks like I kept this car 23,000 miles, probably a couple years before I got that 2006 GTI, which changed my life forever. To the next pick, and ignore the stamps here. The timestamps are just pictures of pictures type of stuff. This may be accurate. It may have been 2006 February when I sold it, but I'm not sure. Of course, it was APR tuned, so I'm going to get into some of the mods I did now for this car. And you can see up here I had some custom hosing, which I'll show you my manual boost controller later. So I started with maybe a P-Flow, just a new speed P-Flow, the most common one of all. Most people went with this. There wasn't quite as many choices way back 11 years ago, and I always trusted Newspeed, so I just went with the Newspeed for my intake, one of my first mods. Did I notice any difference in power? Not really, now that I think back on it. Back then, oh, I noticed a lot, you can be sure of that. I mean, that's when I was barely 30 at that age. Here you can see my manual boost controller. There was one guy that sold these, I cannot remember his name. Oh, it's right there, Jerry or somebody who made these custom manual boost controllers. So you would loosen that lock nut and you turn this knob and literally just adjust exactly how much boost you wanted. I custom made that little loop to hold this hose in place, and tuning was kind of easier back then. You can see also the screwed up stuff I used to do, drill holes for amplifier power blocks and stuff right into the firewall, all messy holes everywhere. Things were a lot different 15 years ago, or 10 years ago, sorry, I'm getting a little confused. A better pick, and with the N75 module was your boost control module over here with the gold and brass you're seeing, and people would replace that with the Audi N75J. I believe my stock one was a G. You'd replace the J from an Audi, maybe a TTS or TT something, and you'd gain a couple PSI in that. It was calibrated for a couple more PSI, so you'd combine that with the fine tune of your manual boost controller using your gauge and make sure you got just the perfect boost. If I think back, I probably was at about 22 was the max you wanted to go on that, or you start getting real risky. What's next on this car? Oh, the wheels. These were the 15s, as I said, and I upgraded to 16s. These were called Bourbets. That's all I remember. Bourbet, a French wheel or something. And I think I have one pic showing them on the car, which just it fancied it up a little bit, because even 15 to 16 was real nice in this rim size. Next, I went with a heat shield for all these coil wire wraps, which were right at the hot spot back there with the turbo. See, I think I have the pictures backwards, but you can see that's the end result, and here's what it kind of looked like coming up. So you'd put the heat shield under there and you'd snap it down. And I have one more pic there showing what the piece was. So that was a heat shield protection part for your wires, which would get so hot and brittle that they'd crack. And this was a preventative measure for those 1.8 Ts. Next, I went with an EIP. I don't even remember that frickin' tune that brand anymore. EIP tuning dog bone mount for my tranny. Even back then, I remember, I think I took this off pretty quick, just like nowadays. I think it was too much vibration for me. Here's a pic of it installed coming up. Actually, the pics got mixed up. So let's jump to stereos. All right. So that's the stock speaker on the left, and looks like I went with Focal Polyglass for this particular car. I can't remember. I've had so many speaker sets, 20 to 30 speaker sets in my life. I just have to go by picks. So these are Focal Polyglass. They might be Slims, but I can't tell unless I had a side pick of those. And a custom adapter that I was making to out of MDF and glue. And you can see I mounted the crossovers on the back of these doors. This looks like a rear door project, especially because what the picks are called. So I think this was a rear door project here too. And you had custom adapters here to mount it in the rear door and get just the right spacing on that. So that's kind of how it ended up. That was real nice. You had to pre-drill that MDF with a pilot hole before you screwed these in, or these screws are going to split your MDF. Now it's back in order. Those stereo ones were out of order. There's my final EIP tuning dog bone that I had set up. I didn't keep it too long, it was too rough. Next, I went with a Tyrol Sport upgraded side mount intercooler. This is the stock one you're looking at here. And now we're going to look at the Tyrol Sport upgrade. You see them in comparison right here. It's about twice the thickness, extra long, at least twice the volume, at the very least. It did require a few modifications though, trimming a couple plastic shields and things like that. Pick of it installed coming up right there. And you just have to trim a couple bumper pieces, very minor, and you had a way bigger intercooler setup there. I got 2 minutes left on this timeout video. Suspension, let's see, these are just random picks. I tried three different sets of shocks on this. I started with some Konies, or maybe the Bilsteins. So these are some Konies that I looked at. I tested them, of course. These are some Bilstein HDs with all new bump stops of various heights to test. I tested some KYB AGX, which I love because of their adjustability. It was just so nice custom tuning the exact one you wanted. And the fronts here had one, two, three, or four adjustability, so you can make them as soft or as strong or as weak as you wanted, as soft or as firm as you wanted. Next, some more picks comparing. That would be a Koni front to a Bilstein HD, and the little technique I have to tightening the top strut nut properly is using either an Allen, if that's the type, or a socket for mine there. And you would hold it and then torque with a crowfoot with a wrench, spark plug wrench, say with a hole in it. And this ratchet went through it to hold the center. So it was kind of like you have to make sure you torque these right or you'd have a lot of problems. Next, we're coming to the end. That's just a big pile of my parts, all my Koni parts, my New Speed Soft Sport springs, I believe, that I ran for a short bit and then I got rid of those too. Almost done here. There's another Bilstein HD setup. Every little part I had to buy is a pain in the butt. Then I went with an Autotech rear sway bar. You can see that here. And this is showing the stock stereo, and it's going to show some decks that I used, an Alpine, and then an Eclipse. And an amp setup like that. and I had some PPI amps too, sub boxes, and finally the power. That's the end of my video. Thanks, guys.